Welcome to our Friday workout. We're gonna have so much fun today. I'm excited. We're gonna work our whole entire body today. We got the weights, we got the band, we got the mat and the bench. Those are the things we need for today. And then we're gonna start with my very favorite warm up. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna keep the band on top of the thighs if available. If not, do not worry. And again, I'm gonna start with a modification of the exercise and then I'm gonna make it harder and harder as we go, okay? So the warm up, I wanna keep the heart rate up and get you nice and tired on the warm up. So we're just gonna keep going, okay? We got the weights in your hands, you got the band on the top of the thighs, if available. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna start with little bicep curls. Now, if your elbows are a little sensitive, you might wanna go lighter weights or just keep moving the legs instead of the arms, okay? So what we're gonna start with, we're gonna do a little tap forward for the modification, right? To make sure the knees are nice and soft, shoulders are down, chest stays open.
Begin set one.
Beautiful. Good. Nice. Good. As you do it, make sure the hips are nice and aligned, right? So we're starting with this. Now to make it a little bit more challenging, we bring the leg forward. Now this is only if your knees feel good. If you have sensitive knees, go back to number one, okay? So that modification. Good job. Your elbows are close to the body. I know you're thinking, Evie, this is still too easy, but wait a minute. It's gonna get harder, I promise. Good job, everybody. Shoulders are down, knees are soft.
Exercise.
Good, let's keep going. So now we're getting your quad warmed up, your hip flexors, a little bit of stability, balance, and biceps. So now for number two, what we'll do, we're gonna do a little back tap. So we're going backwards, and that's coordination actually as well. Nice, shoulders relaxed, chest stays open, very soft on the knees, good. Now to make it harder, if your back and knees are good, you just do little kicks, back kick. Keep the core super tight, keep your tuck, squeeze your tushy, nice, and make sure the back doesn't arch, good. If you do have a sensitive back, you wanna go back to little taps, beautiful. Keep going, nice. Hopefully by now you're starting to feel the bicep.
Stop.
Good going.
Exercise.
Woo, come on. Nice, knees are soft, good. Now we're gonna switch it to high knees. Now, if you do have a sensitive back and knees, just do little calf raises, up and down on your toes. Knees are soft, but if you wanna make it more challenging, start with the high knees. Good, the band is making so much more challenging for the low abs. Beautiful, nice, good. And as you go down with the weight, control it on the way down. Good job, everybody. Woo, come on. Let's do this. Nice work. And I want you to imagine your body's nice and tall the whole entire time. The hips don't rock, they want to. Keep going. Good form. Shoulders relaxed, chest stays open.
Exercise.
Nice work. Now for the final one, we're gonna do a little side tap. Knees are soft, or if you wanna make it harder, you do the side leg lift. Woo, I'm feeling the biceps. Good job. Nice work. This is our final one. This is a great warm up. I'm getting a little out of breath right now. And after this, we're gonna keep our band and we're gonna go into a bridge on the floor. Let's keep one of the weights so we can work on the balance and stability. And I'm gonna start with the modified version and then we're gonna make it harder. Good job, everybody. Woo! Let's do this. Don't stop. The elbows feeling it. Just move the legs. Keep going. We never wanna give up. Very good, almost there.
Stop exercising.
Woo! Nice work.
Next
okay, session. Let's keep one of the weights and let's go down on the floor nice and slow. Now, abs are super tight. We're gonna keep that one arm up. We're gonna tighten the core. If you have a sensitive back, just hold this position with the abs super tight. If you are able to do bridges, but the back sometimes gets sensitive, just lift the hips off a little bit up the floor and squeeze the glutes and hold that. Make sure there's no pressure in your low back, right? Squeeze in the abs, hips nice and aligned, shoulders relaxed. Now, if you want to make this harder, you extend your leg out, right? The hips are still aligned. Imagine you have a water bottle or a glass of water on your hips, and you hold this, squeezing everything in the body. Now, if that feels still too easy, you move that leg to the side.
Exercise.
Good. Keep going. Let's do five more. We're going to switch sides. We got 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do the other side. And again, so if you have a sensitive back, start with the abs in and the arm up. Then make it a little more challenging by lifting the hips high. Then if you want to really make it more challenging, you go one leg out. You're still staying on the same arm to make it harder, but the leg is changed, okay? Keeping the abs super, super tight, everybody. Woo! Good work. I know you're excited about this workout. Try to keep those hips nice and high. You can either hold the leg up like this or move it side to side. The movement will challenge your core. Just squeeze the abs and don't let the hips move. Nice. Woo! My goodness, I felt that hamstring. Let's switch sides again. If you don't need that break, stay on the same side for two. Always make it harder. Good job. Abs are super tight. See how my heel is pushed in? My toes are up like that.
Begin set.
If you're
three.
Doing both legs or one leg, either way, you're still keeping the toes elevated. Good job, babies. Shoulders relaxed. Good breathing. Good. Nice work. Imagine we put a glass of something, glass of wine maybe. A good wine. We don't want to spill it. Shoulders down. Good breathing. I can't see my hips, but hopefully I'm nice and aligned. Think about the hips staying aligned, ladies. Good. Woo, I'm burning in the hamstring.
Stop.
Woo. Let's switch sides. So the arm stays same arm, but we're switching legs now. Tighten that core. Again, we're getting the hips, the hamstring, abs, balance, stability, a little bit of everything. Nice work. Good job. Last
Begin
one.
Set four.
I know you got it. Let's do it, ladies. Woo! Come on. After this, we're going to do some skull crushers and dips. Good. Nice. So we're going to start with skull crushers for whoever's got sensitive shoulders. And we're going to do dips if the shoulders are good and your wrists are good. Abs are super tight, so I'm going to show you some modifications for the tricep exercise. Abs are super tight right now. I'm burning. Woo! Let's keep going. Make sure back
Stop
is good.
Exercise and
nice.
Switch
Take
to
a break,
the
ladies.
Station.
Okay, so I'm going to grab the other weights. We've got two weights. If you're sticking with the weights, you can go a little heavier if your elbows are fine. Now, if you have a sensitive back, keep your feet down. Keep your abs in. Go down to your forehead. Down for five, up for two. Okay? This is if your back is sensitive. Okay, if your back is good, no tension in the back, you're going to lift one leg up and then the other leg up, okay? Keeping the core super tight so your back is flat. You're going to go in, up, and extend the leg. Actually, no, you know what, don't extend it because it's too much going on and I think your back might come off. Just go in, exhale. In, going down. Try to really focus on tightening the core. Good. Don't
Stop
let that back
exercise.
Come off. Good job. Nice. Inhale, exhale. Now, if this is challenging, keep going. Now, if your shoulders are good and your neck is good, wrists are good, we're going to make this harder. Okay, so same idea. Triceps still working.
Begin set two.
Abs tight. Shoulders down. You're going to keep your palms facing forward, and you're going to slide down the bench or the chair or whatever, the bed, whatever you have available, and then you're going to come up slowly. Make sure your shoulders don't go up. Keep your shoulders down. Down slow, elbows tucked in. Come up, squeeze. The elbows want to go out to the side. Don't let them. Slowly going down. See how my knees and my ankles are all aligned so the knees are safe. Exhale on the top. Inhale going down. Exhale coming up. We're actually going to just take a quick break for the wrists and the neck and the shoulders. Some of the exercise, I have you go a little longer, but I worry on this one on the wrists and the shoulders. So take a quick break. We'll make this a little bit more challenging. Now, if you back and wrists are sensitive, stick to the tricep on the floor, okay? Good job, everybody. Let's do it again. So now we're going down slowly. Then we're going to go up. We're going to lift that knee up. This is low abs. I know you've been wanting to really work on the low abs, ladies. Inhale, exhale, lift. Good. And when you hear the break and you're like, Evie, this is still too easy, you get to keep going. Lift. Beautiful. Abs are super tight, looking right in front. Make sure there's no pain in your shoulder or your wrist. Okay, watch the wrist. Inhale down,
stop.
Exhale, lift. Let's take a quick break for the shoulders and the wrist. Woo! Nice work, everybody. We got one more. Then after that, we're gonna do our side leg lifts, your other favorite one. Coming your way, we're gonna give your wrists and shoulders a nice little break after. So we got that chest open. Not about you, but I'm getting a little bit out of breath over here. Woo! Go down slow, coming up, lift. See how my heel is kind of pushed in, my knee and my ankles all aligned. That will protect your knees as well. Inhale, exhale, lift. When you lift the leg, think about squeezing the abs, like there's a punch coming to the stomach and you want to squeeze it super tight. Inhale, going down, exhale, squeeze. After this, we're going to go on the floor, keep the band. We're going to do some side leg lifts with low abs combined. Woo! Come on.
Stop exercising.
Nice work, everybody. That was a hard one. I felt the burn. Woo! Okay, so now let's go down on the floor. If you have a sensitive back, just start with the one hip on top of the other, little pulsing clamshells, okay? If your back is good,
begin set.
You're gonna keep that band available, body in a straight line. You're gonna bring your knee to your chest, kind of on the level of the shoulder, squeezing the abs, not rounding the back, kicking it out and up. Let's see, knee comes in, kick it out and lift. If your knee's not liking the knee in, don't worry, just go up and down with that leg, okay? Make sure you're protecting that knee. Now this hand's gonna go here just to help you balance a little bit and lift. Beautiful. Knee comes in.
Exercise.
Kick it out and lift. Very good. Let's do two more. Knee comes in, that's low abs, bring it up. And the last one, stay on the same side right now. Good. And now I want you to just do through the break little circles for the ankle. Let's warm up that ankle a little more.
Begin set two.
Good, nice work. Now let's point the toes down and let's do that burnout. We're gonna go up for five, a little bit lower for five. Up for five, a little lower for five. Nice, squeeze the abs. Woo, come on. I know you got it. Keep going, body's in a straight line. Bottom knees bend. Nice, exhale through the mouth as you come up, slow release, nice work. Exhale, squeeze, woo! The hips are gonna be on fire.
Stop, exercise.
I hope you've been really sore after my workouts, ladies. I've been sore, so hopefully everybody else has been sore too. Good job. And again, if your back is sensitive, just do little tiny pulsing clamshells. Now again, remember the second side is always harder, right? Because we already worked this side on the other side. Now hips nice and aligned, that knee comes in if the knee allows you. Kick it out, pointing the toes down a little bit and lift. Nice work, knee comes in, that's low abs. No rounding of the back and lift. You know how much I love planks, wall sits, side leg lifts, all the core exercises. So we're always gonna do a variation that, okay? They're really, really good for the body. It's so important to work the hips, ladies. So always a variation of a side leg for you.
Exercise.
Nice work. Let's do two more. One. Good. And then one more. Nice. And then keep it up now. Now do a little circle just for a couple seconds, warming up the ankle a little bit, keeping the hand in front for support, squeezing the abs.
Begin
and then we're
going to
go up for five. Lower slowly. Good job. Woo! After this, let's keep the band right where you have it, okay? We're gonna do an ab exercise. Very good. Abs are super tight, so I'm gonna start with the modification again. Very good. Shoulders down, and again, you can bring your head down if you're worried about your neck. Good. If you do support it like this, make sure you're not shrugging the shoulders. Keep going, everybody. Woo! You got it! I don't know about you, but I'm burning! Okay. We're going to do some bicycle crunches now. Now, I'm going
to
show you different variations of them, okay? So, again, number one, if you have a sensitive back and neck, you're going to tighten that core super tight, okay, as tight as you can. Squeeze in the abs, right? The modification for it is going to be to bring that knee in and kick it out if your knee allows you, okay? Only if your back feels good. So, you're pushing your back in, you're squeezing the abs, right? So, you would do one leg, two sets, and then you would switch if your back is sensitive. Now, if your back is okay and you want to make this harder and your neck is okay, you hold the crunch, you lift yourself up like this into this position. You bring both legs up, tighten that core so the back is flat again. If I wanted to put a piece of paper underneath my back, you would say, no, Evie, you can't do that because I'm engaging my core. You're going to whoo, so you shake it and bring it back. Push through the heels. Good. Now, when you bring your knee back, make sure the back feels good. Very good. So, again, I'll just show you quickly. You could either do it this way, with a crunch or without the crunch, going back and forth. Or to here, going out, squeeze the abs. Look at me shake it and bring it back. Woo! Keep going. Extend it, squeeze the abs, push it down. Good, chin is high, elbows are out. Make sure the shoulder feels good. If you have a sensitive shoulder and you're trying to support your neck, you can bring that elbow in a little bit. Good going. Nice. I'm going to make this a little bit more challenging in a second. Woo! Keep going. Don't give up. Exhale fully as you're kicking that leg out. Bring it back. Good. Exhale, squeeze the abs. Bring it back. If that's too easy, keep going. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put that band over my feet now. Now, only if your knee like it, okay? If the knee doesn't like it, go back to the other version. Squeeze in the abs super tight. Make sure back feels good on this. You're pushing it back down.
Three.
And then you extend it. Good. Squeeze the abs super tight. Bring it in. What I'm doing, actually, I'm moving it to the side a little bit. That makes it more challenging for the core and the hips. Inhale. Exhale. Squeeze. Woo! And guess what's coming next, ladies? We're going to get to do some burpees today. Woo! So much fun. But don't worry. It's going to be a modified burpee. And I'm going to show you the right form. And if you can do a burpee, you can do a plank. Good going. Abs are super tight.
Stop.
Woo! Keep going. Again, if this is too much for your back, go back to where the band was on the top of the thighs. If that was too much, you bring one foot down and you either hold a crunch or you keep your head down. I know some of you have sensitive necks, so let me try to keep you safe. Always safety first. Good job. Keep going. The abs are the low abs are on fire. I know all of you have been requesting a lot of ab work, so it's coming. Woo! After we finish with this, ladies, we're going to keep the band over the top of the thighs for the burpee. And we're going to go to the chair or the bench, whatever you have available, or the bed. Good going. Woo! If you want to make it harder, go faster. We're really squeezing the abs. Make sure there's no tension in the neck or the back.
Stop exercise.
Woo, that was a good one. Now the band is going. Oh my goodness, my abs are on fire. The band is going on top of the thighs, ladies. And what we're going to do, we're going to come up to the bench. If you have a bench or a chair available. Now, if you worry about your knees or this doesn't feel good, you can always just hold a plank, okay? So we're starting with a plank position. Squeeze in your tushy super tight. Now, see how my back is flat. I'm going to bring my knee all the way in forward. I'm pushing through my heel so my knee doesn't go past my toe. And then see how my back is flat. I'm pushing through the other heel. Then I come up and I go tippy toes. Okay, this is a version, an easier version of the exercise. Now we're going to go out again, squeezing your tushy super tight. Bring that one heel in, pushing through the heel.
Exercise.
The other heel in, back is flat, squeeze the abs, tippy toes. Okay, so that's the easier version. Let's make it a little bit more challenging. Now, the whole time your back is flat, if you worry about your back or your knees, just hold a plank, whichever variation you would like. Keep squeezing the tushy. So now let's make this a little bit more challenging. What we're going to do is we're going to bring that knee. We're going to go a little faster. Push through the heels, push through the heel, and do a little hop. You only do a hop if your knee allows you, okay? And then out one leg, out the other. Squeeze the tushy. Hold it for about 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring that heel in. Back is flat. Push through the heel. Let it hop. Woo! I'm gonna make this harder. Do not worry. If that's too much for the back, knees, shoulders, anything feels funny, wrists, just hold
Stop.
It flat.
Exercise.
Either forearms or straight arms. Either one is good. Push through that heel. See my flat back? Never rounding the back. Pushing through the heels. Woo! Keep going on this, ladies. Good. We're gonna make this a little bit more challenging in a second. Squeeze that tushy. So now let's add a little something.
Three.
So now we're gonna add a little mountain climber. Going in, set it down, squeeze the tushy. Go in, set it down, squeeze the tushy. Slowly push through the heels, slowly through the heels, and come up. If you ever wanna do this on the floor, ladies, you're more than welcome. And I'm gonna show it to you at the very end, okay, how to do it on the floor. Squeeze the tushy super tight. So one knee in, set it down. The other knee in, set it down. Heel, heel, little hop. Hopefully everybody's getting a little out of breath. Woo!
Stop.
Good job. Very good. Squeeze that tushy super tight, okay? As tight as you can. So keep going. If you're okay there, I'm going to make it a little bit more challenging. Make sure your back is never rounded on this, okay? Good job. Very good. So on the floor, squeeze in the abs. I would bring the leg almost to the side a little bit, keeping my back flat, the other side, and a little hop, okay? Back is flat the whole time, out, out. Squeeze the tushy. One leg comes to the side a little bit because I want to make sure it doesn't round my back. And up, keep going. Back is flat, keep going, a little cardio work. Squeeze that tushy. And after this, we're gonna do our favorite wall sits. Woo! Keep going, everybody. Back is flat.
Stop exercise.
Let's do one more. Squeeze the tushy super tight. Leg goes to the side. Everything's aligned. Back is flat. Woo! Nice work. Good job, everybody. Now let's keep our band. I know you're excited to keep it. I think we're gonna use it for the whole workout today. You could grab a little lighter weight. Two and a halves are perfect.
One.
Threes are perfect. Fives are good only if you have good shoulders and good back. So what we're gonna do, again, wall sits are pretty amazing. You can do them with sensitive knees as long as they feel good. You can stay up really high if the knees are sensitive, or just go a little lower if you wanna make it harder. Push through the heels, back is flat. If you have a band, make sure that there's tension on the band. You lift your toes up, okay? And then you're gonna start with little punches forward.
Stop, exercise.
Good. When you do the punch, it's gonna get us out of breath a little bit. Hopefully everybody's out of breath right now. And it's not, I'm not the only one. Keep breathing, ladies. Woo! Back is flat. Shoulders are down. If your back comes off,
that
might put pressure on your low back. We're going. We're not stopping. If that's too easy, go lower. Only if your knee feels good. Nice. Breathing. Everybody's breathing. Now let's cross it over a little bit, but don't move the body. You're just crossing the weight. If you have sensitive shoulders, ladies, just keep the weights on top of your thighs, okay? We don't want to go too heavy on this. Shoulders are down. So it feels pretty good on my shoulders right now. No pain in the shoulder. But I'm feeling the arms working. Good. And I'm getting my heart rate up a little bit too. Keep going. Good.
Stop.
Keep going. We're not stopping. No way. Good. Now you can almost do like a little uppercut too. Good. Keep that back nice and flat. Good. Shoulders down. Keep moving the arms. It's all about the movement. We never want to give up. And I will always make sure I'm challenging your whole entire body. So see how you're working your legs and your core and your arms? If you have a sensitive shoulder, just keep the weights on top of the thighs. Or elbow. Or back, too. Make sure that we keep that back nice and safe. Keep going. Woo! Don't give up. Hopefully you're burning. Good job. For the last one, I'm going to go even faster with the weights. The weights are going to go out in a punch really fast. And then the plank is coming, your favorite one. And if you already did a plank with the burpee, instead of doing
Stop
the burpee, it's okay. Never enough planks. Woo! So now let's speed it up. Don't go heavy on those weights, ladies, because that will pull on your back. Whew, I want to get that heart rate up right now. Keep going. Come on, you're burning in your thighs, not the knees. If you feel the knees, come up higher. If you feel your low back, put the weights on top of the thighs. For your next exercise, you're going to keep the band for the ab exercise, which is a core exercise, actually, we're doing. It's a plank. We're going to work your tushy, too, and your obliques today. Woo! I know you're excited. Keep going. Never give up. Shoulders are down, never pain in the knee. You go up higher if there's pain in the knee. Double check if the knees and heel is aligned. Woo! I'm gonna do, I want you for the next one, do that plank elevator,
stop
okay?
Stop exercise. Woo! And switch to
good
the next
job, everybody.
Session.
That was amazing! Nice work. So now, again, let's start with the modification. Modification is either knuckles, if you have sensitive wrists, or on your hands like this, squeeze that tushy, knees are soft, okay? And you're just holding it like this. Now from here, if your back is good, you can make this a little bit more challenging. You're gonna cross it over to the opposite elbow, opposite knee. You're gonna bring it back, squeeze your tushy. Now this is the easier version of this exercise, right? Because we're on straight arms right now, which is easier for your back, whew, and easier for your shoulders. Good job. Squeeze that tushy. Again, anytime I move the legs, I like to be a little bit elevated for the back. Now see how every time I bring my foot back,
stop,
I readjust.
Exercise.
Squeezing the tushy super tight. Now if your wrists are getting tired, go on the knuckles. See if that makes a difference. If it doesn't, just go onto your forearms, okay? Just make sure there's no pain in the shoulder or the back or the neck or the knees. Good. Squeeze that tushy super tight. We're going to cross it over. Bring it back. Squeeze your tushy super tight. So give it like a 5-second squeeze. Cross it over. Squeeze the tushy. You don't want to feel the back. If your back or knees are feeling this, hold the plank. There's always a modification for everything. If those planks are too hard, do them on the wall. Do them on like a counter. Somewhere where it feels good on your back and your shoulders. Woo! Come on. Keep going. Squeeze that tushy.
Stop.
In.
Exercise.
Set it down. Squeeze that tushy. If this is not challenging enough, keep going. But I am going to make this harder, okay? So, again, if you have good back and good knees and you want to make this harder, we're going to add a little side movement to this, okay? So, we're going to focus on one side. We're going to start with the right leg. Squeeze your tushy. Bring that knee in. Set it back. Bring it to the side. Squeeze your tushy. When you bring it to the side, don't go out far, just a little one. The farther out you go, the more your back's gonna wanna work. Woo! Keep going! Squeeze the tushy super tight. So you got the obliques, bring it back, squeeze your tushy out to the side hips. Squeeze your tushy, good job. If you need a little break for the shoulders, ladies,
stop, exercise.
Go up, straight arms or knuckles, either one. And then switch sides. Bring it in. Bring it back. Squeeze that tushy. Bring it out to the side. If you need that break, take one. If you don't, keep going. Nice. Knee comes in. Squeeze the tushy.
Set four.
Hands directly underneath the shoulders. My shoulders are burning right now. Woo! Knee in. Bring it back. Squeeze your tushy. You want to make sure as you look at me, see how my hips want to dip? Don't let them. Squeeze that tushy. Readjust it every single time. We're almost there. Then after this, I'm gonna show you your stretches. We got some good stretches. We're actually gonna take our band off for the stretches. Woo, that's coming after. Oh my gosh, shoulders are on fire. Keep going. Squeeze that tushy super tight.
Stop exercise.
Woo!
Our training is now complete.
Oh my goodness gracious.
We did it.
I'm feeling the burn in the shoulders in a good way. My hips, my abs, hopefully you're gonna be so sore. Yes, I know you will. Okay, so what we'll do, we're gonna sit down on your chair or the bench or the bed, whatever you have available. Be careful on the knees sitting down. Keep your back flat. We're gonna take that band off. Good. This is actually one of my favorite stretches for the hips. Now make sure your knee feels good. And this is a great tip for when you're putting on and taking off your shoes. That's a good one. So imagine you're just sitting down and you want to take your shoes off and stretch at the same time. So what you'll do, your back is flat, never rounding the back. Squeeze the abs. you have a sensitive back, be very careful. Bring your leg up to where your knee feels good. Flex your foot. See how I could tie my shoe right now? I could take it off, put it on. Now, let's look at your back, okay? So now you might already feel the stretch in that one hip, but you might not. So if you wanna make it harder, you lean forward with your whole body coming in. Make sure there's no roundness at the back. And you really feel that piriform is stretching there. Very good. Abs are super tight. Make sure that knee feels good. Don't pull on the knee too much. Beautiful. Abs are super tight, leaning forward a little bit. You can push that knee out a little bit if you want, but watch that knee, protect the knee, flex your foot. That will help your knee. Now let's switch sides. Same idea. Tighten the core. Squeeze the abs. Relax your shoulders. And don't overdo the stretch. Make sure it feels good on your knees and your back. You cross it over. Let's say you want to put your shoes on, but you're having a sensitive back. This is the way to do it. Actually, if you could do it every day like this, that would be perfect, because then you're not putting any pressure on your low back, and you get to stretch and put your shoes on at the same time. So, again, back is flat, shoulders are down, and then you could push into that knee a little bit, lean forward, but don't make sure there's no roundness of the low back. So you're kind of hinging that hips coming forward, breathing. Really feel that stretch right here. For some of you, it might be too much. If it is, don't overdo it, or just do like a child's pose or a cat and cow, whatever feels good on your back, okay? Shoulders relax. Again, don't round the back. Open up that chest all the way. Very good. Nice. And then take a break. Now we're going to come on up. Now we're going to push for the heels, okay, to come up from the chair. So it's like a squat to protect your knee. And now let's stretch the back a little bit and the hamstrings. So what we'll do, you can hold on to the something. You can either do it with the chair or whatever you have available that you can hold on to. And just lean back a little bit and push through your heels. So see how my back is flat, I'm not rounding the back. And I'm just kind of pushing through my heel, stretching the back of the leg, my hamstrings, and my low back, okay? Relaxing the shoulders. This should feel good on the back of the leg. You shouldn't feel any pressure on the knees. The back is nice and flat. Good job. Let's go. 10, 9 is a great one for the back and the hamstrings. We don't even have to go on the floor. We can do those stretches. Woo! We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly coming up. Very good. Nice work, ladies. So there's more stretches on the YouTube channel that we have. They're amazing. And then, ladies, also don't forget to do your cardio today. It's beautiful out there, so I'm going to actually do it right after this. I'm going to go for a run. Now, if you have been doing cardio, let's say on a flat surface, and your knees are fine and you want to make it more challenging, try out the hills. Go do something different that you haven't done to challenge the body in a different way, okay? And also, drink lots of water, 8 to 10 glasses a day. I've been really good on my water, actually. I've been carrying my water with me everywhere I go. Actually, mostly at home, but wherever I go, at home, I have my water with me. And you did amazing. That was so much fun. Hopefully, you're gonna be sore in your glutes, abs, quads, shoulders, and I miss you. Good work. Woo! We did it.